Welcome to a GTAP presentation. Today's presentation is on preparing the GTAP database for GAMSpace Global CGE models. Many of you are familiar with the GTAP database. You download it from the GTAP website, and when you first download it, you'll be downloading the classic GTAP database. It contains four files in the HAR format, H-A-R format, which is the format used to store data by the Genpact suite of software. The classic database, which has been around for many years, has these four files. The DAT file, the DAT file, essentially contains the social accounting matrices for each region, country in the database, and the bilateral trade flows. All of these flows are measured in millions of dollars with a specific reference here. So if you're downloading the 2014 data, it will be in 2014 prices and market exchange rates. The PAR file, P-A-R file, contains a set of key elasticities used for the GTAP model. The VOLE file contains the energy balances, and these are in units of millions of tons of oil equivalent. The EMIS file contains the CO2 emissions that are linked exclusively to the combustion of energy, and these are measured in units of millions of tons of CO2. In 2017, we made some key changes to the GTAP model, which required some changes to the database, and we are now calling this new version of the database the standard database as opposed to the classic database. It contains the same four core files, but with modifications. Let's walk through the changes to the core files, beginning with the DAT file. The first change are the naming conventions for many of the parameters that are included in the file. These are described in the background documentation. The second change has been the inclusion of a make matrix. This allows us to differentiate activities from the commodities they produce. The third is that we've converted the CGDS activity, the formation of capital goods, and we've made a separate investment column. So we're treating this the same way we treat private and public expenditures. We've made production taxes activity and product specific. So this is part of the make module. And we've converted factor income taxes to be both activity and factor specific. In the classic database, they were only factor specific, so uniform across activities. Changes to the PAR file. We've added a regional dimension to the key production elasticity, E sub T, and E sub VA. Because we've modified the production nesting a little bit, we needed an additional elasticity called E sub C, which represents the substitution across intermediate demands. And we've set this equal to E sub T, which was the previous top level elasticity. For the make module, we need two separate elasticities. One is a transformation elasticity, ETRQ, which is activity-based. So for each activity that produces multiple commodities, it's transformation across those commodities. We've set the default value to -5. E sub Q is a CES substitution elasticity. So for each demand for commodity I, this represents the substitution across the source activities. We've set the default elasticity here to infinity. In other words, we're assuming perfect substitutability or the law of one price. Note that in the Genpact version of the database and the model, perfect substitutability is given by the value 0, because in the Genpact version of the model, the function has been inverted to deal with perfect substitution. We've given the user more flexibility as regards the expenditure functions for government, investment, and the formation of trade and transport services. So these are now generic CES expenditure functions with the relevant elasticities E sub G, E sub I, and E sub S, with default values 1, 0, and 1, which were the default values in the classic version of the model. We've given an added regional dimension to the two Armington elasticities, E sub D and E sub M, though at the moment they are still uniform across regions. Finally, for GAMS users, we've identified perfect factor mobility by the value of the transformation elasticity. So a transformation elasticity of infinity signifies perfect mobility. Partial mobility then is given by a finite elasticity. Finally, we've made changes to the VOLE and EMIS files, and this simply reflects the separation of the investment accounts from firm accounts. We are providing a GAMS file that will proceed in four steps. The first step, which is optional, is to extract the core classic HAR files from the distributed zip file. It depends on a specific piece of software that you may not have, so you may need to manually unzip the distributed files after the download. The first step after that is to convert the classic HAR files from HAR format to the GDX format, but the GDX files will still have the classic format. The second step then is to convert the core classic GDX files to the new standard GDX format. And finally, there's a step that will erase any intermediate files if the user requests it. All these four steps, the optional one and the three other steps, are integrated in a single GAMS program that the user needs to modify for their specific setup, which we will explain in the next few slides. There are four possible locations or folders for the different files, and all of these can be the same or they can be four independent locations. So the first one is the location of the zip file, the one that you download, and that will be in the GTAB zip directory, which you will need to specify. The second location is the location of the HAR file. So after you unzip the distributed file, the downloaded file, you need to zip it to the HAR files to its own folder, and we call this the indir folder. Then we need an intermediate folder, GDXdir, which will contain the translation of the HAR files, the HAR classic files, to the classic GDX file output. Then the final folder will contain the final output. We call this outdir, and this will contain the standard core GDX files. So, and again, let me reiterate, all the locations can be in the same folder, but we allow users to put them in independent folders. It is up to them to decide. So we work on all four core files. We have specific naming conventions for these. The initial HAR-based data is assumed to have a base name of GSD. So we have GSD.dat.har, GSD.par.har, GSD.VOLE.har, and GSD.EMIS.har. The intermediate GDX files will have a user-based base name identified with base name, for example, GSD. So the user needs to specify what that base name is. And then finally, the new standard GDX file will also have a user-based name identified with base name F, for example, GSDF for what we're calling the facelifted files. So from this slide, the user needs to specify the base name that the user wants for the core GDX file and the base name F, which is the standard base name files. Let's start with step zero, which extracts the HAR files from the downloaded zip file. This step is optional. So it extracts the four core GTAP classic HAR files from the distributed zip file. To turn this feature on, you need to set a flag called if extract HAR to on. The default value for this parameter is off. To be able to use this feature, you need to have a working version of a utility called 7-zip. You need to provide the name of the 7-zip file, the executable version of that file, in the parameter called zip.exe. And if it's not in your normal default path, you may have to put the full path name to locate the executable. You need to indicate where the zip file is located. This is in the GTAP zip dir parameter. You need to indicate the name of the zip file, and this is stored in a parameter called GTAP zip name. Finally, you need to indicate where the output of the zip file should be, the unzipping of the zip file, and this should be in the folder called indir. So the first normal step is first to convert the HAR files to GDX. There is a utility called HAR to GDX, H-A-R to GDX, which is just a standard executable file that does this conversion automatically. All right, this must be in your path somehow because it needs to be found. It assumes that the HAR files are in the folder indir, and the output from the HAR to GDX utility will be put in the folder GDX dir. You must specify a base name for these intermediate GDX files, for example, GSD. The second step converts from the classic format to the standard format. It will convert all four of the classic GDX formatted files into the four standard GDX formatted files. More details are available in an accompanying documentation on what that conversion entails. It assumes that the classic GDX files are in the folder GDX dir, and the output from the conversion will be put in the outdir directory. The user must specify a base name for the final GDX files, for example, GSDF. Step three is a cleanup process. Again, this is optional, all right? So you can request to delete all upstream files, both HAR and GDX. This is driven by a scalar in the code called cleanup. Cleanup can take four values, none, then no files are removed, HAR, only the HAR files are removed, GDX, only the intermediate GDX files are removed, or both, in which case the HAR and GDX files are removed. Note that this GAMS program does not create the folders, so that's up to the user to make sure that the folders are created, nor are they deleted. Execution. All four steps are embedded in a single GAMS file called convert.gtap.gms. Before invoking the GAMS program, all user-based information needs to be entered. See table on the next slide. The program has no command line options and can be invoked directly in the GAMS IDE or in the Windows docs box using the command GAMS space convert GTAP. So here's a summary of the user options and the different steps in which they would be used. So if you look at the bottom, those are the step zero only deal with the unzipping of the downloaded zip file. Otherwise, the user needs to specify the three directories, all right? The first one, which contains the HAR files, the classic HAR files. The second contains the classic GDX files, and the third contains the final output, the standard GDX files. The user needs to specify both the base name for the classic GDX files and the base name F for the new standard GDX files. And then finally, the user needs to specify the level of cleanup, whether it wants to clean up all files or just a subset of the files. This is the end of this presentation. Thank you for watching, and please get in touch with us if you have any questions.